I've done what I can, but the rest is up to you. You need to start taking better care of yourself. Understood. And thank you. The curse has spread. Make sure she rests.
If it hurts, you can tell me, you know. I'll understand.
I can bear it.
But you shouldn't have to. Not anymore.
This isn't just your struggle, Clive. It's ours. And when we see how hard you fight, it inspires us to do the same. Or would you rather we left you to save the world all on your own?
No. That's not... Ignore me.
Clive, where are you?
In here.
What's wrong?
Rosaria's under attack.
What?
This isn't the Dalmechian army we're talking about. It's the men of the Rock from Drake's Fang. Hugo Kupka's private guard. They're raising hell in Rosalith. Trying to batter down the castle gates.
Looking for me?
Seems that way. Reckon old Hugo has finally worked out who Cid really is.
Then this is just another trap.
It's a trap, all right. The daddy of all fucking traps.
I'm going to Rosalith.
You're not serious. That's exactly what he wants you to do, Clive.
Look, I don't know why Kupka harbors such a grudge against Cid, but as long as it's left to fester, our world will never know peace. He has dragged the rest of Storm into this pointless war just to find me. Beside which, I'm not about to stand and watch while my home gets ground into the dirt. Hugo Kupka must die.
I've lost enough friends to that man already. I don't want to lose any more. So let's go and kill the bastard.
I'm coming too. After all, we're in this together.
All right. I should probably speak to Otto before leaving. We need to know what we're getting ourselves into.
We must be ready to leave for Rosalith at a moment's notice.
Gov gave you the news, then. We're leaving for Rosalith. But not before I know exactly what's going on. What have we heard?
All sorts. Nobody was expecting the Delmex to open up a new front against the Empire, least of all our friends in the provinces. Reports have been rolling in from all over the place, with no two saying the same thing. I've been passing them on to Vivian, in the hope she can make sense of them. If you set on going, you'll want to talk to her.
Understood.
If it isn't my favorite pupil. Let's see now, where did we leave? Well, this is a surprise. My lectures are rarely so well attended.
You know what they say? A little knowledge, can't hurt?
We're going to Rosalith to deal with Kupka. What's the situation there?
Woe there, Lord Rossfield. I'm sure you're champing at the bit to return to your roost, but to fully understand the present situation, one must first understand how it came to be.
Let us begin with the story of Hugo Kupka, or the permanent economic advisor to the Dalmekian government, to give him his formal title. In a republic founded on commerce, there could hardly be a more influential position. It has granted him both extraordinary wealth and extraordinary power. Not that he ever wanted for the latter. Being Titan's dominant, he is also Dalmekia's last line of defense, a fact he has used to his considerable advantage. Why, he was even able to pry Drake's Fang, one of the pillars of the republic, from Parliament's grip. And he was quick to buy the loyalty of the Fang's protectors. Today they are his faithful creatures, a private army in all but name. The selfsame army that marches upon Rosarian soil as we speak. By which I mean Imperial soil, not that you need reminding of the fact. Suffice it to say, the Empire's attentions are elsewhere at present, deadlocked as it is with Dalmekia over its occupation of the Crystalline Dominion, where its legions are now gathered. Scarcely a handful of garrisons remain to secure its western provinces, and half of them left after the fall of Drake's Breath. With the threat of the Ironblood thus diminished, they had little cause to fear a maritime invasion. And so today, only a token force guards the former duchy's shores, as Kupka was quick to descry. He landed his troops on the Rosarian coast without encountering so much as a single ship. All for you, Clive. He wants your head. And so he and his men advance upon Rosalith, not to capture the province, but to draw you out.
You said Kupka's forces sailed up the coast. What of Port Isolde, then? Is the city safe?
Quite, according to the Guardians of the Flame. The Dalmekian fleet floated by without incident, but not without remark. When they learned Kupka's forces were making for Rosalith, our friends were quick to begin arranging the exodus of her citizens. And so the stage will soon be set for your heroic homecoming. Alas. It will be a more trying task to enter the capital than it was to leave it. Hugo's men hold Bewit Bridge, despite the Imperial's repeated attempts to wrest it back from their grasp. And they were careful not to repeat the Empire's mistake in neglecting their coastal defenses. The seas around Rosalith are firmly under Dalmekian control. So tell me, pupil mine, what do you believe to be the best route to Rosalith?
The north. We cross the northern border near Phoenix Gate, then take the road through Stillwind down to the capital. Hardly the quickest route, but at least we won't be spotted.
A little local knowledge goes a long way, and so must you.
We'd best get a move on then.
Oh, will you be going too?
Aye. I've been waiting a long time to give that fucker a taste of his own medicine. I would have missed this for the world.
All right. We should be on our way.
Lead on.
Fortify the castle gates at once.
Hugo and his men have been busy.
They've already breached the castle's outer wall. The Imperials are holding the ground for now, but it's only a matter of time before the keep falls.
Those fuckers really went to town on this place. Almost like they want to wipe it off the map.
Just a means to an end.
All this for one man? They didn't have to go so far.
If you keep your wits about you, I reckon you can make it up to the castle without raising the alarm. I'll sniff out any townsfolk who haven't escaped yet and send them on the way.
Be careful.
Likewise. Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
It's like a nightmare. This was our home. Come on, Clive. We have to keep going.
It's a massacre.
He'll stop at nothing, Clive. Nothing. Get through here.
It's murderers!
And there's only one fitting punishment.
What we have here.
Gentlemen!
You won't escape!
Yeah! out!
Get out of my city, or die!
Too slow. Ugh.
Set her loose!
They have a curl.
Attack!
Ready?
What do you think?
Make this count.
Nice try.
Jill!
We meet at last, Cid. Or should I say, Lord Rosfield? I've been looking for you for a very long time.
Let her go, Kuka.
I'm so glad you accepted my invitation. I went to some trouble with the decorations. Do you like what I've done with the place?
Bastard!
Such a pity your predecessor couldn't join us. But I am sure you will prove compelling company. Be still, little snowflake. I would not have you melt before your starring moment. Now, on to the festivities.
Just great, that is. I suppose it's up to me then.
Where do you want me?
you! Bring the prisoner!
Yes, no more than she deserves for getting into bed with an outlaw.
We should get into mine.
Lord Kupka commands your presence.
You're to bear witness to the girl's execution.
Such a waste.
Gav!
Crystal fetters are a bastard to open, just so you know. Don't worry, I'll have them off before you can blink.
Where's Jill?
In the courtyard.
Shit. We have to hurry.
The Imperials have sounded the retreat and cleared out of the castle, but the place is still swarming with Kupka's men.
Leave them to me.
I'll make my way up top and circle round the back. Quick as you like, eh?
Nearly forgot.
Hold on, Jill. I'm coming.